What's up, guys? This is Point Man here to give you a commentary against my 1v1 match against LH Luke Puke, who plays as the Ottomans and I play as France. And during this match, and this is a live recording in a live something? No, just a live commentary. That's what I was trying to think of. Okay. Kind of killed there, but I'm going to continue. Well, I'm just going to reposition my cav on his flanks, just normal basic flanking over here. Now, the thing that he did, he brought a good amount of cav, just three Pahi cavalry and three mounted set infantry or mounted infantry cav and two Sepahi cavalry. And he placed them all on one flank, so I had the not only one more cav than him, but he placed it all on one flank, so I was free to outmaneuver him on this side of the field. So I figured, alright, I'll take my cav, go behind his forces on this side, and start pushing up, because I know I'm going to get that cav support. So you really have to take a lot of focus, a lot of time to look at your formation real quick before you actually do it. So I'm going to push up on this flank, try and give him the impression I'm going to begin my assault on this flank. And as you can see, he's going to move his cav on this flank. He's not going to focus on his center, because I'm going to start pushing up down the center also. And while I'm doing that, I'm going to attack behind. So I'm out-microing him considerably. He formed into a square, but very late. He formed a square here in time, though, so he stopped my charge. But my lancers are going to continue to go through there, and I'm going to change their target to these rifles, because since he was moving his infantry behind, I sent in another cav rush just to get rid of these rifles, because I really want to keep pushing out with my infantry. Let's check out on this flank. So here, I'm going to go for a full-out cav rush, my lancers, and these are pretty much lancer counter-cav right here. These mounted cav. So I sent in only one lancer just to absorb the shots, and I sent in my old guard to return some shots of their own. So right here, some very accurate shots upon his cavalry, and they're very packed up together. So since they're very disorganized, I'm going to send in a second Leaguer Lancer cav rush right here. So as you can see, his guys are low on morale. One of them is, well, three of them are routing now. About to be fourth. So, by keeping all his cav on one flank, I really didn't have much to worry on the other flank as well. So I'm overwhelming this flank, knowing that I have the cav support, so I'm going to be very aggressive not only on this flank, but on the opposite flank as well, because that's where I put my old guard. So I know I'll be able to easily overwhelm his troops, since they don't have any guard-type units. So I'm going to push off my old guard, disorganize him first, push up with my old guard, deal with him that first shots if I can. And I'm depleting his number down the center because he's sending support for his flanks. So I'm going to keep on attacking his guys from behind. That's going to disorganize him for a bit. He's going to form into a square formation. While he's doing that, I'm going to push out my Polish legions. Take some free shots from his rifles. But I'm still going to attack him as well with my Dutch Guard Lancers. So here are his Lancers. I'm going to keep on targeting his whatever cavalry he has left, and the only real cavalry he has left is this Sepahi cavalry and his depleted unit of his general bodyguard. It's about to rout too. He was trying to send some support for it, try and save him, but he really wasn't there in time. I did a number on his general's bodyguard before he sent some support, and it looks like a lot of my lancers are routing, about four of them, and one of them is very depleted, or the rest are depleted, but that's still enough to do a considerable amount of damage to his troops. Like, I'm being chased by a Sepahi Sepahi cavalry right now, but I'm still going to attempt to do a rear charge to his troops, and that's going to make them rout. Either way, they would still rout, because these are old guard, and I drew his Sepahi cavalry into the range of my old guard as well, so it was pretty much a faint charge just to draw his cav in. And right here, I'm going to take my Fusilier of Line and form into a square formation, but that was really a pointless little move to do anyway, because his cav just routed. So I'm going to continue my attacks, overwhelming his forces on the flanks. He was winning on this flank, so I had to, like, retreat a little, but a few of his units stopped routing, like these riflemen right here, so I'm just going to target them in melee. I'm not even going to bother shooting them, because really, Polish Guard and other infantry types shouldn't skirmish with skirmishers. That's not their purpose in this match. I let the skirmishings be done with the skirmishers, so just rush with them. So I'm just gonna mop up whatever units came back from routing. And his last unit left is his Sedit infantry. Oh, look, another came back from routing. Another Sedit infantry. It has 45 men in their unit. This one has 53. And they're standing their ground. That's pretty good. So the Ottomans are a considerable force. I guess you need numbers to gain a significant advantage against your opponent, especially France. Usually I'm outnumbered, but you have to pressure attack against your opponent. Knowing that your opponent has these overwhelming odds and these overpowered units, you need to really push your efforts against your opponent. Like, he had the range superiority while I had the cast superiority. So if he was just a little bit more aggressive, he would have beat me in that, and he would have drew me in a lot closer to his units, giving him the free shots. But he did very well in the flank. He turned my flank with my Polish legions, so he dominated those Polish legions, make them look like militia. But no one could really stand up to those old guards, so I believe that's why I won on the opposite flank. So this was a very good game against my opponent Luke, and I'll accept your rematch whenever you're ready.